Ricky Gervais' Afterlife Series 3 has just dropped on Netflix. But which of the three series is the best? Hello, thank you for joining me. My name is Carl. Today's video, I'm going to try and put all three Afterlives, which was written, created and directed by the very talented Ricky Gervais, in some sort of order. It's going to be very difficult to choose, something I've never actually done before doing a series. All three series are available to stream on Netflix now. I've just finished the third and final series on Netflix, and it got me thinking afterwards. Which one of the three series is actually the best one? Very difficult choice because all three series are good in their own way. And we are talking about the life of Tony from series one right the way through to the final series, series three. Please do join me in the comments. I'd love to know for this video, what's your order of the three series? Which ones did you like best? Please do put them down below in the comments. And if you're interested in watching my Ricky Gervais' Afterlife Series 3 review, I've done a review on that one. I'll leave the link for that video down below as well. Ricky Gervais is a comedy genius. We had The Office, Extras, and now we have Afterlife, which is the most watched series in history with over 100 million views worldwide. In series one, we dive into the life of Tony, who is a journalist for a local newspaper, played by Ricky Gervais, who is really struggling with grief and life in general after losing his wife Lisa to cancer. And this really does hit home how difficult it really must be to lose someone close to you. But which of the three series is actually the best one? I'm going to try and put all three series in some sort of order. Please remember, it's not the right order, it's just my order, just my opinion. I'm also going to be putting the trailer of each series in there as well, so there will definitely be some bad language in there as well. Just a little bit of a warning. All three series was very good, but one of the series has to start at number three. So let's start off at number three. Afterlife Series 2. There were some very funny moments in this series. Remember the yoga class? But this one comes in at last place for me because of the psychiatrist played by Paul Kay, who is a fantastic actor, but I just hated his character. Every turning of the crowd, you should know that I'll be with
you. People think all those things I miss doing with Lisa, I could just do them anyway. They're missing the point. I miss doing nothing with Lisa.
Be strong. Everybody's struggling. It's not always their fault.
The last thing you should do is drink alone.
When she died, everyone tried to help me and they sort of saved me.
I feel that I should help the people who helped me.
You look sad.
Oh, that's a waste.
I know a guy who's really into you.
What's wrong with him? Can I just use your bathroom?
Honestly, I don't know where to start.
Fuck me.
I thought you were having a piss.
Thought I'd have a wash.
Fucking hell. I'm not gonna let arseholes find me out.
Try any more zen.
Hear that?
Shine your heart forward.
Fuck that.
How is that relaxing? It's disgusting.
See you next Tuesday.
You're not wrong there, you fucking snot-curdling cunt.
Number two. Afterlife Series 3. The latest in the Afterlife series comes in at middle spot for me. I've got to give you a reason why I'm putting them in this order. And for me, I just felt there was a couple of inappropriate scenes that didn't really need to be in series three. Although series three will definitely take you on a rollercoaster ride of different emotions, which I really did enjoy. And it will also keep you guessing right the way through to the end, which was really good as well.
Thank you.
I've decided to go on a little trip to scatter my dad's ashes.
Oh, that's sweet.
My ashes?
You're not my dad, remember?
Am I adopted?
Fuck me, it's like I've got a replacement. I thought not caring was a superpower. I was wrong. Caring about stuff, that's what really matters. Kindness, making other people feel good.
What are you doing?
Just sprinkling a few of my dad's ashes.
On the carpet?
Yeah, it was his last request.
Oh, was it? So, two of you, out. Take your rubbish with you.
Rubbish?
Ah, that bit went in my mouth.
Good. I hope that was his cock, you stupid cunt.
I hope that was his cock, you stupid cunt.
It's just a discussion.
Don't know what God is exactly, but I believe in something.
Vague.
Well, we obviously go somewhere.
I wish I hadn't teased her about there not being an afterlife now. I think she wanted to believe in, like, heaven and angels and stuff. I hope she wasn't scared.
There are angels. They don't have wings and live in clouds. They wear nurses' uniforms and work hard to pay the rent on their houses. If you want to be an angel, you've got to do it when you're alive. Be good, do good things.
I don't want you to worry. Don't worry about me. Just worry about you, yeah? Be happy. Be kind. Be Tony.
Number one, the best of them all, Afterlife Series 1. This is the first time we get introduced to Tony and all the other characters as well, and we can see that Tony is really struggling with grief. We can see the washing up piling up in the background, and he even starts to eat a tin of dog food as well.
If you're watching this, then I'm not around anymore. But don't spiral, don't obsess. Keep going.
So how are you?
A good day is when I don't go around wanting to shoot random strangers in the face and then turn the gun on myself.
Bad then.
I thought I'd leave you a little guide to life without me. You're lovely, but you're absolutely fucking useless. Stay active. It's not ideal to be a fat, lazy, self-pitying lump.
Pedo!
What?
Pedo!
I'm not a pedo. And if I was, you'd be safe, you tubby little ginger cunt.
You know how grumpy you get when things don't go your way. But you've got such a good heart. You're born like it. You're just decent.
This is Sandy. If you could show her the ropes, tell her what's what.
Humanity is a plague. We're a disgusting, selfish parasite. And the world would be a better place without us. Is that the sort of thing you meant?
No.
How's Lisa?
Oh, Jesus, she's dead, Dad.
Bring Lisa with you.
Fuck me.
You can't just go around being rude to people.
You can, though.
Your dog should be on a lead.
Oh, right. Oh, sorry, thank you.
What? He is not a fat, hairy, nosy cocksucker. Sorry about that.
Disgusting.
If I do and say what the fuck I want, and then when it all gets too much, I can always kill myself. It's like a superpower.
That's the worst superhero I've ever heard of. Why don't you throw yourself into your work, okay? That's what depressed people do.
We're putting out a free local newspaper that no one cares about.
That's not true.
I've seen lonely people dying, people in pain. I don't think I've ever met anyone quite as sad as him.
Got something for your front cover. Freddie Mercury's tooth.
He's disgusting.
Brian, not everyone can get in the paper.
Not everyone's fingered Jackie Collins.
Have you?
No.
Cheers.
Okay.
See you again.
And that is my order for Ricky Gervais's Afterlife Complete Series 1 to 3. I feel that all three series are very good in their own way. They're all very funny. They all contain bad language, a couple of inappropriate scenes, but it does all even out. If you haven't checked out Afterlife yet, all three series are available to stream on Netflix now. Pop over there and start them because they are all very good. A lot of funny laugh out loud moments in there. Please do join me in the comments. I'd love to know for this video, which order of Afterlife would you put your three series in? Please do put them down below. I'll get back to you. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video. If you like this video, please do give it a like. Also, don't forget to share and subscribe if you can, because it really does help the channel out. Thank you so much for taking the time. I will see you guys in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.